is beginning to rain, 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 in the voice of our Father. Saying, whosoever will come drink of this water, I promise to pour my spirit out on your sons and your daughters. If you're thirsty and dry, look up to the sky, it's beginning.
Hello, friends. This is Tex Mars, inviting you to worship with us today at Bible Home Church, coming to you from Austin, Texas.
Well, hello, dear friends. Glad to be with you here at Bible Home Church. Right now, while I'm recording from our studio, which is a little ways from there, we're looking out. I see three deer eating bird seed. Why are they eating bird seed? Well, that's a different story, I suppose. We put out bird seed for the birds, and then the deer seem to enjoy it a lot. I don't know why they would, but in any case, they really enjoy it. And sometimes we've seen five or six deer out there at once, along with an assorted skunk and many squirrels and such, which our cat loves to chase. But it's wonderful to be out here near nature. You know, today we're going to be talking about how you can enter a state of nature with God. Isn't that interesting? You say, well, I don't want to do that. I'm a city person. Well, that's okay. It doesn't really matter. You can be hemmed in on all four sides with concrete and bricks. But did you know you can still be in a state of nature with God? And more than that, we're going to talk today about how God thinks. Now, that may seem very presumptuous of me to tell you that we're going to look at what God thinks or how he thinks, but I think there's a key to my doing so. You see, I just use the scriptures. In fact, in the first chapter of Genesis, my good friend Bob Treves, who puts out a publication called the Cherith Chronicles, sent me his publication this month, and you know, began to read that, and he always has some good ideas in that. But one of his thoughts was very significant, and I'm going to sort of amplify on what he talked about today, about how we can discern the mind of God. Now, a lot of people, can you imagine? I mean, there are people that should be willing to give everything they own just to understand how God thinks. You know, it can change your life dramatically. And certainly for the better, to know how God thinks. You know, I know how I think sometimes, and it just gets confusing and goes this way and that way and weird. And, you know, if I don't get in line with God, I can just get all messed up. Well, we're going to be talking about how you can line up your thoughts with God, but you have to understand some basic concepts. And in the short time we have here today, we're going to sort of start looking at that. And I think you're going to sort of, you're really going to enjoy it. Who wouldn't want to know how God thinks? He doesn't think like you and me, so how does he think? We're going to see just the way God works, his mind. And I love it because all I want is just a little bit of understanding of how God's mind works. And man, that would amplify my strength, my mental agility. I mean, I wouldn't be caught up in emotions. I wouldn't be a slave to mental manipulation by society. If I could just know how God thinks, and I'd grab onto that. Wouldn't you, my friends? Can you imagine? Well, a lot of you like to write to me and tell me that you enjoy the message. Don't you? You don't? Well, write to me anyway, even if you did not enjoy the message. I'd love to hear from you. And, of course, as always mentioned, if you feel led by the Holy Ghost to give to this ministry so we can contribute to God's Word going around the globe, we would love to have a love gift from you. But it's not mandatory. Of course, it's not. Our program is free. Well, here we go with some music now. This is from the Gaither Gospel Series, God Gave the Song album. It's entitled, I Just Feel Like Something Good is About to Happen. And it's sung by Terry Blackwood, Stephen Hill, and Lady Love Smith.
Just to praise him, for I know he's working all things for my good. Every tear I shed is worth all the investment, for I know he'll see me through, he said he would.
He has promised honor in the heart of Father. Something good is about to happen.
It's just about to happen.
And brother, this could be that very day.
I just feel like something good is just about to happen. And brother, this could be. Sister, this could be. Brother, this could be that very day.
Well, I want to thank the Gaither group for their wonderful album and that song. I'm Pastor Tex Mars of Bible Home Church. Today we're going to be looking at an area that I think is so fascinating, the mind of God. Now, of course, you cannot possibly fathom the entire mind of God. It'd probably blow our brains apart to even imagine that we could. We simply don't have the capacity to have all of the intelligence. We don't have that capability. But listen, there are some principles that are vital that God has told us. Now, I think those who don't know Jesus Christ as Lord are going to be mixed up. They're not even going to understand what I'm saying today. But if you know Christ as Lord, you're going to really appreciate what I have to say. If you'll turn with me, my friends, to Genesis chapter 1. Genesis chapter 1, we start right at the beginning. See, God wants you to know a little bit of how his mind thinks. How he patterns matter, let's just say, since you and I are matter and we're spirit. And in what I'm going to tell you today, I'm going to tell you how you can be a free person. You can have freedom. Freedom. I'm going to show you how, if you can understand the mind of God, you will have freedom and liberty, and your soul will be at rest. That's an amazing thing, isn't it, my friends? Okay, we begin with reading verse 1. It says, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Okay, first of all, let's just stop there. In the beginning, God. Not in the beginning, there was some rock up in space that blew up, the Big Bang Theory. I'm not going to get in all that evolution junk. In the beginning, God. The first principle, the only one that counts, is God. Man wasn't here. The planet that we see today was not here. The animals weren't here. The plants were not here. And you and I were not here, nor were our ancestors, of course. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. He created it. It was out of nothing. Verse 2 says, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. Friends, listen very carefully. I believe that everybody is created by God. And at the beginning, you're without form, and you're void, and you're dark. You understand that? You're born in darkness. You're born, really, you're not fully formed. And you can stay that juvenile, unformed creature for all your life. In fact, for all of eternity, if that's your choice. But God would like to create a new creature in you. He started it off by just creating you in flesh and blood and spirit, but you're not born again. He wants to resurrect you as a new creature. You think about that. But at first there was void and there was darkness and the earth was without form. It was chaotic, my friends. There was darkness and chaos. And God brought order out of chaos. Now, the Masonic Lodge and the other occultists today say that is their goal, to bring order out of chaos. Well, they cannot do that. They will never be able to do it. Only God can bring order out of chaos. If your life is chaotic and you go from crisis to crisis, don't think that psychology or psychiatry or any man-made system can pull you out of your tailspin. They'll just put you right into the vortex of a tornado and you'll end up worse. But God took the earth, which was without form and void and dark, and he moved. He moved on that, it says, the Spirit of God. Verse 3 says, and God said, let there be light, and there was light. Friends, is there darkness in your life? God can simply say, let there be light. Let there be light. And God saw the light that it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. Ah, this is the way God thinks. Why didn't it just stay dark? Why didn't he just say, I'm going to let it be all light, all dark? Now we see a personality trait of God. That's right. I'm already able to divine and discover the mind of God here in a small way. Listen to me, my friends. God has a discriminating mind. He divides. Now the whole world says, let's all come together as one. Let's be in unity. Let's end all of our divisions. Let's forget all of our petty doctrinal differences. Let us just love one another. The world says, let us have unity. But then along comes God and says, I'm going to divide. Did you know that in the last day, he says, I'm going to divide the sheep from the goats? And the Bible says that his word is like a great sword, and it cuts and it divides. Wow. Some will go to eternal damnation. Others will go to eternal bliss with Christ. He divides. And he did it right here in Genesis. He divided the light from the darkness. He began his work. And you, my friends, are either part of the light or you're part of the darkness. There's no gray area. The world likes to say, there's no absolutes. It doesn't really matter. You can be a Buddhist or a Hindu or a Muslim or a Jew or a Christian. It doesn't really matter. We all worship the same God. You see, they all try to put everything together, to bring together a synthesis. I'm not going to get into you about the Hegelian dialectic of Marxism and all of those things. But that is the same concept, to bring the two opposites together, the yin and the yang, and become one. This is the reason for the double-headed eagle of Freemasonry, their major logo, the two heads as one, on one body. But that's the way Satan works. He brings together things. Isn't that amazing? He unites things. Now, the only time Christ will unite things is when you become a new creature in Christ, then you will be one with him. But while you're in darkness, there is no way to unite. There's no way. There's no method that God has arranged for people to be united as long as they're in darkness. Number 5, and God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. He gave a name to the darkness and the light. And you know, he gave a name to the devil. He names things. In the New Testament, it says that it was at Antioch where those who loved Jesus were first called Christians. He gave us a name. We're a Christian. That means we're of Christ. We belong to Him. And that's the whole concept of in the beginning God. God created. And the Creator is God. And He deserves our worship. And you will never be happy, and you will always be a slave until you worship God. Remember an old song by Bob Dylan? Remember him? Because he was a reprobate in many ways, but for a short while he said he had conformed to Christianity. Then he backslid again, unfortunately. But while he was a Christian, he put out a Christian album. One of the songs was sort of interesting. He warned people, you got to serve somebody. It could be God or it could be the devil, but you got to serve somebody. The president of the United States may be president. We know he really doesn't serve the people of the United States, but I'll tell you one thing. He's ordained by God to be president, and to the extent that he serves God, he will succeed and prosper. But when he deviates from the godly path, misery comes in his life. I think that's a principle. A spiritual principle applicable to the President of the United States and every king, every potentate, every prime minister, chancellor, every CEO, every truck driver, bus driver, janitor, secretary, manager, it doesn't matter. You got to serve someone. Let's go a little further. He says, and God said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters. Friends, there's water in the clouds in the sky, and there's water down on earth below, and God divided it. He wanted to, and that's what he did. That's his personality. That's his mind. And God made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament, and it was so. And God called the firmament heaven. Named it. That's heaven. This is earth. Because verse 10 says, and God called the dry land earth. And the gathering together of the waters called he seas, and God saw that it was good. He gathered together the waters. Listen to me, my friends. You come to know Jesus Christ as Lord. You're born again with him, John 3, verse 3. And you will be gathered by him. And you know what? Jesus is coming in the last days. 1 Thessalonians and 2 Thessalonians says that he is going to gather up the saints. Just the way he gathered together the waters and made seas. Because he is the living waters. If you're the part of that living water, you're going to be gathered up. If you're not, you're going to be dry land, my friends. You're going to be left high and dry. Now listen to this one. And God said, let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after his kind, whose seed is in itself upon the earth. And it was so. And the earth brought forth grass and herb yielding seed after his kind, and the tree yielding fruit whose seed was in itself after his kind. And God saw that it was good. Did you know that God divided then again? He severs, he divides, he discriminates between. Hey, some plants became herbs. Some were grass. There was fruit. And each one was of its own kind and had the seed in itself. And you know, we as human beings have the seed in ourselves. And that's why the woman from the seed produces a child. And that child should be a seed unto God. Did you hear what I just said? That child should be a seed unto God. Because a man and a woman cleaving together, becoming one, should have a seed, if they can, after his kind. We can keep going here. Verse 16 says, and God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. See, we keep dividing. Not only does he have light, but he has light for the night and light for the day. He divides and he divides and he divides and he discriminates and he severs and he separates. Does it not say in the Bible, God said, come out of them, that means the evil system of the world and the false religions. Come out, my people, and be ye separate. And I will receive you, and you will become sons and daughters of God. Listen to me. He says, come out, Be ye separate from the world. But most churches today say, I don't want to come out. I want to be part of the world. I want to be accepted. I want to conform. I want to be like everyone else. You see, the devil has always attempted to bring everybody together. But listen to me, my friends. If you're of Jesus Christ, you are different. Because you have a seed in you. God has planted in you a seed, and it will bring forth fruit after its kind. And it is different from all of the seed in the world that is of the devil. And everyone out there is producing seed of their kind. And that's why we have the wicked and the evil. But you are different. If you're the same, then you've lost your salt. You've lost everything God gave you. There's nothing of God in you. Now, I want you to understand something, my friends. This is so very vital to understand. If you do not understand that you are to discriminate, to separate, to sever, to divide, you're in trouble. If you don't understand that God, for example, let me go on here a little bit further. Verse 27, again, Genesis chapter 1 says, so God created man in his own image. But wait, it says in the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. He divided the man. He made the man both male and female. Not both, he separated them. There we have division. There we have separation. A lot of people say, Tex, don't you get a lot of criticism for the way you preach? Of course I do. I'm different than the rest of the world. I've separated myself from the rest of the world. Now listen to me, my friends. Here's the key. You can serve God or you can serve the devil. You can be in unity with all the peoples of the world that the devil is putting together. Remember they built the great tower at Babylon? They said, let us all be as one and let us build a great tower into the heavens. They would be like gods, would they not? But wait, God came and he says, I'm not going to have you all be one. I'm going to separate you. I'm going to divide you. And he gave them all different languages and they couldn't speak to each other and they were confounded. The same principle. Did you know the devil is trying? He's got a new world order. He's bringing all the nations together. Of course he is. Everything comes together as one in the devil's plan. But God separates. And he separates the sinner from the saint. Which one are you, my friends? Now listen to me, my friends. You are going to be a slave to God or you're going to be a slave to the devil? If you have not accepted this division, if you want to be part of the world, or if you're part of some church that says, oh, let's not preach about sin, and let's not try to think that we're better than everybody else, well, let's just all become one with the Muslims and everything, let's love each other, you are in big trouble, because God will say, okay, then fine. Go out there and you will become united with that group. You'll be in unity with them, in fellowship with the devil and his people and his works and his system. And you'll be a slave. Your soul will be stained. Friends, you're not going to have liberty. You're not going to have freedom. Let me tell you the way to freedom. The way to freedom is you accept and believe in Jesus Christ and then he plants a seed in you and you become a new person, a new creature, and that seed begins to grow and grow in you. Now listen, God gives you liberty. The Bible says in Christ Jesus, there is liberty. But you must always do and act according as God would have you and get in line with his word. Jesus Christ said something. A lot of people don't understand it. Let me tell you what he said. He said, if thine eye be single, then thy whole body will be full of light. You know what he meant? Don't be double-minded. Be a discriminator. Yes, be divisive. Divide the good from the evil and take the good for your life. Choose between good and evil. Choose God. Get in line with him and live and be free. And throw off your chains and your shackles the devil would like to put over you. This is Tex Mars. You've been listening to Bible Home Church. May God richly bless you. Amen.
If you're thirsty and dry, it's beginning to rain.
You've been listening to to Pastor Tex Mars and Bible Home Church. Please join with us in worship next week as we continue to honor the remarkable Word of God.